Good day, everyone, and welcome to the Personal Projects Fair of MYP Grade 10 students of Chiang Kai-shek College. In a little while, you will witness the products of our students' consolidation of learning through year-long inquiry and development of important ATL skills they'll need in both further education and life beyond the classroom. Through these projects, students develop confidence to become principled lifelong learners. To the parents and to the personal project supervisors, we thank you for the support you had extended to these students for the success of their projects. I myself have witnessed how they inquired and applied their ATL skills and developed to become independent learners. Apart from practicing and strengthening their approaches to learning skills, the personal project encourages students to develop an area of personal interest. The personal project provides an excellent opportunity for students to produce a truly personal and often creative product or outcome and to demonstrate a consolidation of their learning in the MYP. Thank you very much, and we hope you will enjoy the presentation of our students.
Congratulations, MYP students. MYP 的同学们，恭喜你们完成了自己的个人计划。For MYP students, personal projects are the culminating projects for you to demonstrate the ATL skills that you have learned and prove us that you are ready to move forward to the DP program. I believe looking back at the process, all of you will agree that the efforts you put in are worth it. I hope in this journey, you have understand that you have an active and constant role in your learning. It may not always seem like it, but you are in control of your own failure or success. Congratulations again, and see you in the DP program. 恭喜大家 ,DP 见了,恭喜哦。
Hello everyone, I'm Ms. Maripoli Nicole Mercado, MYP Personal Project Mentor. Today, I am very proud to introduce to you my mentees who really exerted their effort and work hard to produce a product of their passion. To start with, we will have Michelle Chen. Her personal project is entitled Ensemble, a music album that depicts the pandemic. Followed by Clint Denver Ching, who pursued his passion through sticker. Lastly is Diane Leslie Goh, who worked with a book of sceneries that explored different photography techniques and sense of creativity with her personal project entitled Shades of Nature.
Hello everyone, I'm Michelle Chen and today I'll be talking about my MYP Grade 10 personal project. First of all, what is my personal project about? Basically, my personal project is about guitar. With that, the final goal that I want to achieve at the end is to produce an album containing 10 cover songs using an acoustic guitar with self-written lyrics that depicts a pandemic, with a global context of personal and cultural expression, specifically on a part of the ways on which we reflect on and enjoy our creativity. Because in this project, I'll mainly develop and enhance my own personal interests and skills, but at the same time bring affection to people or to the society through what I've learned and what I've experienced in this personal project. For you to have a better understanding, here's an infographic that summarizes what my personal project is about. Now that I'm done introducing what my personal project is about, next, I'll be sharing some of my takeaways or what I've learned, what I've improved, and as well as how my results are after this project. So for my final outcome, as what I've said in my goal, it is an album consisting of 10 songs that I made covers of using my acoustic guitar. And before that, I didn't have any experience in playing a guitar, That's why I learned everything by myself from scratch. I started learning all the basic chords, basic strumming pattern, and more. And at the same time, I started to think of the songs that I'll be covering for my album, and also themes that I want to convey in my songs, as well as in writing my own song lyrics. However, because of the short amount of time given, and also because of my procrastination, I realized that writing 10 song lyrics was too tough for me. That's why I decided to change to only 3 self-written lyrics and have 7 songs with the original lyrics. So for the title of those songs with my self-written lyrics are Wild Angels covering Ocean Eyes by Billie Eilish, City in Prison covering a Chinese song that means Summer Wind by Wen Lan, and lastly Empty covering a Filipino song Sana by I Belong to the Zoo. And as you can see, the original songs were all in 3 different languages. I purposely did that because as what my global context is, I want my songs to be extended to different kinds of people in the world and somehow make them feel empathy and comfort while listening to my songs. With that, the other 7 songs are Lego House by Ed Sheeran, Home by Michael Bublé, Still With You by Eric Bennett, Leaves by Ben and Ben, Rainbow by South Border, Talking to the Moon by Bruno Mars, and Let It Be by The Beatles. In case you weren't able to catch up, here's the song list with the 10 different themes of the songs related to the pandemic. Now continuing on. Besides from the songs and lyrics, the most important thing in this project is guitar learning. So learning guitar was not as easy as I expected. Although it was difficult for me to learn guitar by myself in a short amount of time, I still learned a lot of interesting stuff, and most importantly, I improved a lot in my skills. So first of all is my research skills, because I didn't have any professional help from anyone in learning guitar. Therefore, I need to rely a lot in researching and finding different sources that I can utilize in learning guitar. So basically everything that I've learned were all from different apps, websites, videos, and more. Besides that, I also improved a lot in my thinking skills because I basically used my thinking skills in writing the lyrics, and as well as my communication skills because my album is mainly to communicate with different kinds of people all around the world, and I communicated with them through my lyrics and songs. Lastly, although I still lack a lot in the skill, I was still proud of myself that I was able to somehow improve a little bit on the skill, which is the self-management skills. At first, I was really procrastinating a lot and I wasn't able to manage my time well, which I was stressed and worried about my personal project. Luckily, at the end, I was able to push myself more and sufficiently manage my time in accomplishing my personal project. And after all, I was able to successfully produce something, although I still have a lot of things that need to be improved, I still did my best and challenged myself. So for the remaining time, I'll be playing the 10 songs. But before we get there, I hope that you won't judge me with the music because I'm still currently learning and improving on my guitar skills. And also, I'm not a professional singer, so please bear with my terrible voice and my guitar playing. Thank you very much.
To the moon, trying to get to you.
Heaven knows what you've been through. So much pain.
Let it be.
Life goes on and on, so baby, home. I'm just too far from where you are. Leaves will soon grow from the bareness of trees, and all will be alright in time. Empty, the place once had been loaded with. Sorry, we're closer all around. How can we even? These are temporary, empty is what it seems. Learning from the past and pain is what we need.
Hi everyone, I am Clinton Reaching of 10AA, and for today, I will be talking about my personal project. Firstly, what is my personal project? So my personal project that I have chosen is printing stickers, but since COVID has set a barrier, I have focused more on designing my own stickers. With this kind of personal project, I have chosen personal and cultural expression as the global context that I will be focusing on. With this global context, it will help me show what I have been doing over this quarantine and show my emotions through drawing some stickers. Personal project is important to me because in the future, I want to be like my parents, as they inspire me to study hard and start a business as I grow up. So, to help you guys understand what I did for my personal project, I have decided to make an infographic. This infographic is a short summary of my personal project. And here's it. Feel free to pause the video if you want to see the infographic. The start of my personal project, I really wasn't sure of what I would do, but I have chosen printing stickers because I could express myself while utilizing the global context. And for a long time, studying at school, comes the increase that I've always had in mind. I have always wondered what the experience of starting a business is like, because these things are not taught in school. So then I decided to start a business and draw some designs for my stickers. For the first few months, I have focused on doing the worksheet. And here it is. Then I planned on what to draw, and again, since I chose personal and cultural expression as my global context, I chose to express myself for the experiences that I have this quarantine. While taking action, I still had some doubts on my personal project because I wasn't that creative kid who likes to draw, but I was the kid who wanted to vent out expressions through drawing, even though I don't know how to draw. But with the help of my supervisor, I have gained confidence on what I would do for my personal project, and I was able to pursue the drawings that I have. And here are three of my products that I have made. So on the first one, you guys can see that it resembles a guy on his computer. And this drawing symbolizes what I do every day for almost a year. I have been doing this every day because of COVID-19. On the second sticker or drawing that I have made, it resembles me watering plants. Over lockdown, there has been a lot of people who started to love plants, as plants have a rewarding feeling if they do. And over quarantine, I have been one of those people who started loving plants. And on the third sticker or drawing, this is clearly a person carrying boxes of homeworks, personal project, and summative assessment tasks, as it has been a hard time for me to, and surely some other students, to manage these tasks at a time during quarantine. The background to these stickers represents the emotions that I feel as blue and green makes me feel calm and red makes me feel stressed. After doing this personal project, I have realized how important this personal project would help me practice some of my skills that I would need in the future. I was able to utilize this global context because I drew these stickers and have asked some people about their opinions. I think the most important APL skill that I have learned in this personal project is managing time. Time management is a very important skill to learn as early as now, in order for me to avoid procrastinating on my tasks. I also utilized some communication skills, as how I was able to ask some friends of mine to get suggestions for my drawings. And I think that the communication skills improved with my personal project supervisor also, as Ms. Mercado isn't a teacher of mine, and we still got to communicate through this personal project experience of mine. I believe that I was able to communicate effectively with my supervisor on the deadlines that we set and both agree upon. I have also utilized my research skills, as how I have researched on benefits of starting a business at the young ages and what the experience of starting one is. Even though I wasn't able to fully produce and sell my products, I would count it as a business plan or something like an experience, so that I can start a business and pursue it once I have some experiences and time. I believe that this personal project that I did doesn't go against my criteria that I have made. And overall, this personal project isn't just pursuing my project, but also practicing my skills to improve in the future, and it will help me succeed. And lastly, here is the criteria that I have created.
Good day, everyone. My name is Tiana Sigo of 10AA, and my supervisor is Ms. Mercado. Today, I will be presenting to you all my personal project presentation, which is entitled as Shades of Nature. And without further ado, let us begin with the presentation. Starting off with the introduction, may I introduce myself once again as Tiana Sigo of 10AA, and I chose photography as the theme of my personal project. And this project is very significant to me because I've been taking photos starting from a very young age trained by my sisters, and since then I've secured great comfort and interest in photography, and now it's become one of my favorite hobbies. The specific goal of my personal project is to let my audience appreciate the natural beauty of our sceneries using photography techniques like framing, the rule of thirds, balance, and all the other photography techniques I could use to take pictures from my phone camera. Some of my goals also include inspiring the audience and hoping that they'll be able to understand photography and art more and also become interested in it in the process. So why is my personal project entitled as Shades of Nature? It is because my project is set to focus on the different shades of nature can appear as, such as colors like red, blue, white, pink, and more. I wish to show people nature's natural beauty and emotions through my photographs. And this message will be in the hands of my photography skills. And my global context, once again, is personal and cultural expression, because it is the ways in which we discover and express ideas, feelings, nature, culture, beliefs, and values. It is also the ways in which we reflect on and spend and enjoy our creativity, and it is our appreciation of the aesthetic, which goes very well with my personal project. Since through photography, I will be expressing nature's beauty and feelings well. The inquiry question I use to explore throughout my personal project is the second inquiry question that I propose, which is what important qualities should photos have in order to be considered as beautifully taken? And along the planning stage, I've drafted some layout sketches which I will use for laying out my photos in the coffee table book. These come in very handy as I will be given many ideas when I don't know how to lay out my photos next time. My planning stage also included some Google Drive folders for all my personal project files, such as a worksheet, the photos for my coffee table book, and the process journal. And every time I update a folder for my photos, I document the process in my process journal always. And there are also themes that I've thought of which can arrange my photos orderly according to the photo's best concepts. And after that, I've also drafted some contents that I've thought of at first for my personal project. And next, I've picked out 5 journal entries from my process journal. And the first one, which is the first meeting, followed by the second one, the third, fourth entry, and the last entry. And all of these I picked out, which I thought were the most important and most amazing entries I've ever did. And on the 4 photos that you'll be seeing here, the upper 2 are the cover pages, which is the first cover page and the cover page which will end the book. And below those 2 are my table of contents. And for the reflectance stage, my criteria is divided into 5 parts. The first is photographs, which take on clarity, attractiveness, photo shots, and photography skills. And next is creativity, and under it is style and ideas. The third is originality, the fourth is project structure, and under it is composition, details, layouts, and formatting and sources. And the last part is overall performance, and under it is relevance, planning, and ATL skills. And before I officially end my presentation video, I would like to share with you all 5 extracted pages from my coffee table book that I pulled out. The first page you'll be seeing is from page 15, followed by page 2, page 24, and fun fact, this page is one of my special pages, and this is to celebrate Pride Month of 2021 in advance. Page 11, and last but not the least, page 25, and another fun fact, this is the last page of my coffee table book. After completing my product and testing it against my personal criteria, I could say that I did pretty well in my personal project, as I've tested it against the highest level and it has met all the requirements. And along the way of my personal project, I could say that I also did grow as a student and photographer, because compared to then, I didn't know how to place the focus on certain subjects when I take photos. But now, I do know how to play with my phone camera more in order to take better photos compared to then. Other than that, I also really enjoyed my personal project overall because it made me become even more creative, and I've also developed my self-management skills more. And I also enjoyed not only because photography is my hobby, but because I was willing to learn and improve per each criterion. It definitely changed my take on photography as per my prior knowledge. And I'd also like to thank all the people that helped me around to complete this personal project, like my sisters, and of course, Ms. Mercado, my supervisor, for guiding me well throughout this personal project. And with all that being said, I would like to conclude my personal project presentation. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed this presentation.
Alright, good day everyone. Over the past months, these students have demonstrated the skills they have developed in the MYP to all subjects and the approaches to learning. They were able to apply the skills to a topic of their choice based on personal interests and talents, resulting in different products which will be presented today by these inquirers and dedicated learners from Chiang Kai-shek College IB MYP Department. I am Ms. Salazar, their mentor, and I am more than thrilled to present my personal project mentees for this year. Let's hear from them one by one, starting off with Tunichi.
Hi, my name is Tunichi Iyasai, and my personal project is all about a sketchbook flip through where I draw the historical and cultural fashions of 7 different countries.
Okay, And let's hear from Hans.
Hi, I'm Hans, and I animated, wrote, and composed my own animated feature film. Mm-hmm. Or not feature, short film.
And we also have Precious.
Hi, I'm Precious Tan Tian Pak, and I created an art wall during this pandemic.
And lastly, of course, we have Madeline.
Hi, my name is Madeline, and my personal project is creating a digital storybook.
Okay, so we hope that you guys enjoy the presentations. And please feel free to ask any questions and give feedback through the comment box provided in this YouTube channel. Thank you so much.
Afterglow. I only have her to thank for the wonders of this land. It was truly a touch of magic. What used to seem so gloomy is now flashing in radiant colors. Everywhere she walked, they sang, bushes and flowers glowing, dancing, beaming of electricity. It was as if she had redesigned this land into a new world and sparked a light deep within each soul. We all had fun together, but as all do, she grew up and had to go. She stepped foot on this land with a paintbrush too thick and colors too heavy. Since she left, she took all colors away with her. Even once, she did not paint. Everything seems blander and more still now than ever. At times, I would still hope for a return to retrieve her bow and give life to all that had been stolen from. But the land never gleamed since. What was left of her was none but a mere bow, laying on top of the dull yellow grass. Her bow was eventually buried into the ground by the plants of the land. And perhaps it was magic, but a flower bloomed, one in the color of her bow. After some time had passed, the land slowly restored its color. But it was no longer a dark sky in need of light, for it had cleared and day was shone upon. Magic no longer overwhelmed the land, and there was balance. It was nice meeting you. I hope you don't forget me as I will never forget you. And maybe one day, it is I who shall show you the wonders this land has to offer. Yours truly. The end.
Hi. My name is Madeline, and this is my personal project. As you can see on the screen, it says Afterglow, which is the title of the digital storybook I made. This storybook looks very amateur, doesn't have that many words, but that's alright, because the intention of this project is for me to learn how to draw on a digital medium, which is something I've never tried before. So it's kind of like practice, which is why, as you can see in the pages, they're mostly drawings rather than text. The goal of this personal project is to hopefully inspire the audience or readers to better appreciate drawings in storybooks or comic books more. And why I chose for this to be the goal is because when you have drawings and colors in a really well-written book, they're often left unacknowledged or overlooked. And it's not a huge issue. It's not an issue at all, actually. But I thought it would be a nice try to challenge myself to create a storybook when it's the other way around. It's the drawings that guide you through the story rather than the text. Or an alternative way to think about this is a movie, where the drawings are the scenes and the dialogues are the text, only there to better explain the situation. The original character I chose to research and base the story on were ghouls, because ghouls, they differ in each culture, meaning that I could just choose characteristics I like from each and create my own version. But I ended up abandoning the idea because, as I've said, I'm only new to digital art, so my coloring skills on a digital medium can only go so far. When I tried coloring my sketches, it ended up looking terrible, very forced, but I couldn't exactly redesign my characters either because this was the exact appeal I wanted for the first story attempt I made. So what I did instead was revise the story in order to redesign the characters. And to be honest, I'm glad I did because that was when I started to see some of the mistakes I made, like how the story was too long, which would have occupied too much space. I thought it was necessary to redesign the characters because if I left it as it is, just sketched and monochrome, then what would be the point in trying to learn how to draw on a digital medium? You could do all those with a pen and a paper. Drawing on a digital medium should be a completely different experience because you have to explore new methods and techniques in order to create a whole different kind of aesthetic. Throughout planning the storybook, I had a lot of ideas that I worked on but didn't end up using. But one thing I learned is that it's always good to write down your ideas or capture photos. And why I think this is helpful is because one, you won't get to lose your ideas, and two, it keeps you sane. Writing down your progress and reflecting every once in a while helps you feel more confident about your work. And it also cancels out all that you have already tried and failed at, so it narrows down to what could possibly be the right answer. It's also good to ask for help from people who have experience, but since I don't know anyone or can contact anyone with professional credentials on digital drawing, I resorted to YouTube where I found tutorial videos, whatnot, from people who draw digitally for a living. The main topic I inquired on was, which drawing app should I use? For this one, I did some research and also asked my sister for recommendations. I decided upon Autodesk Sketchbook because it's a very simple design app. It's very easy to locate and remember its features, and it also provides a lot of brushes, patterns, and other tools. A method I use I found really helpful that saved a ton of my time and effort is collage, and what I do is I put an image here and then I just layer on top of it. And why I think this is so effective is because, aside from saving a ton of my time, it also shows a lot of detail in the drawings since they are already images with shapes and things like that in there. So there are some blank spaces that I don't need to fill in anymore. And I personally really like the juxtaposition between the background and the things at the front as well. Like for example here, as you can see, the hills, they're images from real life, unlike the trees which are cartoon. I really like the mix of styles there. I think it's a signature look of the book. But aside from that, collage also helps in drafting, as you can see in this example where I just adjusted the images and edited their forms in order to create the draft instead of drawing them manually. Overall, I focused the most on the color of the drawing since I can't really rely on text to convey the character's emotions and feelings in each scene. So out of all of the ATL skills, my thinking skills were definitely the most utilized because there were a few times when I had to make decisions when I fight against my own interests. Like for example, maybe one page looks really good alone, maybe it's something that I personally really like, but if I put them with the rest that follow the plan, it looks horrible. There I have to decide upon either editing just this one page but lose whatever goodness it was, or edit the rest of the pages which would take up a ton of my time. Research I did a moderate amount of, but as I've said, since I had a change of plans, there were some that I didn't end up using, but I don't exactly regret since it was the original attempt that led to the final one. As for self-management, I have my supervisor to thank for that. She sets deadlines for me for I won't go off track, and then from there, I do timetables. Like for example, during Christmas break, I had to catch up on a lot. I had a lot, like a ton to catch up on. So I had a plan of working for around 4 hours a day, and I did. I worked around 5 to 6 hours a day during the whole Christmas break, and then starting December, I worked around 2 times a week, usually during independent study periods. Overall, in my opinion, I met the standards of the criteria. Based on what I used to know and where I am now, there was definitely a noticeable jump. And in my opinion, I think I did criterion A and C the best. Ever since I was in elementary up until visual arts class, whenever I have the liberty to choose what I want to do or how I want to do it, I would always just use one pen, either a pink pen or a blue pen, and just sketch with that because it makes me feel more relaxed and controlled. Wanting to get out of my comfort zone was one of the main reasons as to why I decided to change the story. Knowing that the project not only brought me new experiences and lessons, but also formed a new artistic identity in me, for me that's a really unique thing that highlights originality. One of the unexpected challenges I faced in creating the product was learning how to cooperate with myself. I was again and again just torn into two, deciding to either do what I want to do in the moment or do what I plan to do. And what made it so hard was that it's not just some task that I was assigned to do, it was a task that I chose to do, that I wanted to do. So from completing a product, I learned that it's very, very important to have a plan ready and to think beforehand before acting, which is one of the reasons as to why I had a lot of failed attempts, not planning. As an IB learner, I've improved in terms of my approaches to learning while still keeping the IB learner profile in mind. It helped make the process more effective and honest at the same time, with long-term consequences like newly acquired skills. By applying skills like researching and thinking into my work, I'm immediately enhancing the quality of it. Because these skills, they're liberating me to be more open with other people's ideas and knowledge and opinions. But of course, all these would mean nothing without self-management skills, since it's the balance and state of mind. The IB Learner profile helped me not only become a better student, but also become a person with better morals. All in all, this was a very fun and new experience for me. I hope the project served its purpose to remind people to take a second look at beauty, because they might find something that they haven't seen before. It definitely served its purpose for me, and now I really enjoy drawing on a digital medium, maybe more than a traditional one. I hope this video about the process of my personal project could someday inspire someone to have their own. Anyway, thanks for watching, and have a great day! Bye-bye!
Hey guys, what's up? I'm Hans Ulrich Osiet, and this video is for presenting my personal project. So my personal project, as you can see on the screen, is an animated short. I spent the past 7 months working on this 4-minute and 22 long presentation. And the reason why I chose this personal project was because I really like animation. I really like movies and short movies. I think they're very entertaining. That's why I wanted to make my own. My prior knowledge before making this was almost non-existent. I mean, I watch a lot of short films and I watch a lot of films, normal length films, but I never really had any experience making any. So this was a very interesting, very eye-opening experience for myself. And basically how my summary of while making this personal project was a very fun one, but also a very not fun one. And so an experience that had a lot of suffering involved. So before getting into too much detail, I'll now go through my process step by step to tell you all how this happened, this thing that you're seeing. So part one, investigating. Criterion A, also known as investigating, is the phase where I don't do any work. I do research mainly so that I can get more knowledge and more familiarity with the subject I'm working on. So that was animation as well as music composition and writing, but that was a little easier than the other two. So animation first. For this animation, I researched in a very specifically, not a very ghetto way of researching. So what I would do is I'll go to Netflix, I'd search up animation, or I'll just search anime since Netflix doesn't really have any 2D animation movies. And see, these are all the sources that I took in reference for my animation. So I would basically watch animated things, and those would be my point of reference when making my animated short. Now you would say that would be not serious research, but I found this way of researching, so as YouTube, not just Netflix, found this way of researching much more helpful than just watching someone explain how to explain animation and how to animate, because I was being entertained at the same time. And so that was basically how I researched animation, and also just trying it on my own. So I would just experiment with this program. So I chose Krita for my animation program. And basically what I would do is just draw random stuff, like for example, a stick figure. And I would just like change it up a bit every time. So I give it a happy face, sad face. So that was basically what I did, but much more complex than that. So yeah, that was how I knew how I learned how to animate. So next step was music composition. I didn't really look up any videos like I did with animation, because music isn't visual. Instead, I just experimented. So what I would do is I would use this program. It's called Chrome Music Lab. It was a program on your browser. It's like a website where you make music and it's all aligned in a grid. And every time you tap, it makes a little sound. So what I would do to practice making music was just put random stuff here. And then I would play it. And if it sounded good, which this one didn't, so we're gonna throw it away, I would like keep it and like just add more stuff to it in order to make it sound better. And if it was bad, I would just throw it away and make a new one. And eventually it turned into something like this. So that was how I made music. And I didn't even use this for my final product. So you would imagine, actually, This is how much songs I made. So that's basically like 12, 19 probably. So yeah, that's how much I experimented. But it also gave me a lot of experience with creating music. And if this program didn't work, then I could just use the traditional way and use like a real piano. So yeah. And this, I found this one more easy to do since it's like a giant physical one that I can just press around and experiment with faster. So yeah, that's how I practice my audio or music. So my inspirations are once again the Netflix and also some things that I watched on YouTube, like tutorials and stuff. So part two, criterion B, otherwise known as planning. This is the stage where I know everything that I'm going to do already. I just need to plan everything out and put everything their own respective time schedule thing. So my initial scheduling was basically, I would spend the first month, actually, I would spend the first month doing research, so criterion A. Second month, I would plan everything out. And then third month, I would do all the criterion C stuff, like animation, music, and stuff. So here's my schedule. I'll really go through all the words. So I had an initial schedule, but unfortunately, it didn't work out as planned. So you can see here, basically, this is the objective and this is achieved. So for the first like 4 months, it looked pretty much the same. I was consistent with how I planned everything out. But by October, I fell off a little bit and didn't do all the voice lines when I planned to. This is where the downward spiral began. I slowly let my time management skills, or lack thereof, get the better of me, and I procrastinated so much. But I did end up finishing everything, probably. By the time March is done, I probably finished everything. And I found this process very difficult, but I will save all of those complaints, I guess, for criterion C. So writing the script. So writing the script wasn't actually that hard because, like, well, it was hard. Let me explain. So the first script that I wrote, I took about 5 minutes to write because, you know, ideas just randomly pop up like that sometimes. But then when I tried to animate it, so you can see here in my character designs, this is what originally was going to be the final personal project. But then, as you can see, it ended up being a dog. And so what happened was, tried to animate these human people, but then I realized it was too hard and it was going to take way more time than the given month, 7 months, for us to complete our personal project. So I instead opted to change the story to something more simple, change it to like just two characters instead of like 12. And that I changed it to just two because firstly there wasn't enough time, and also because I'm lazy. Okay. So the main goal that I had for my short was that I didn't want it to be possible in live action. And what I mean by that is, originally when we were conceptualizing ideas for what we want our personal project to be, I had the idea to film a real like live action short, like in real life with me as the star. And I realized that that would be really boring. I would probably make it like really bland looking and the colors were just really bad. And so I decided to do animation because I thought it would be more challenging, be more fun to learn. And I thought it would be more interesting to look at for people. And I also think that animation is a very special way of telling a story. It's not like nor other techniques of telling a story where it's straightforward. In animation, you can literally do anything you want and tell a story any way you want. And I think that I should take full advantage of that if I really like animation that much. So yeah, that was my main goal. That was my main plan, to make my animation like that. And I think I succeed in that kind of. So in criterion C, this is the part where I actually do stuff, important stuff already. So I will just show you the whole short already, just so you can get an idea of what I actually made, because you might dislike it. Alright, animated short. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope it wasn't a waste of time for you. So that was what I spent 7 months on. Now I know it may not look like it took 7 months to make, since It's only 4 minutes and, you know, looks like this. But I encountered a lot of difficulties during the process of making this, and I'll explain all of them to you now. So there were four main parts of this criterion C, or this taking action part. First was animation, second was sound design, third was voice acting, and fourth was music. They all come after one another. I did animation first, then all of them after. So the animation was, all of it took place in this program, Krita. It's called Krita. And here's what I had to do. So every frame is basically like a drawing. So I had to like manually draw everything out. So this obviously doesn't, if you understand how animation works, this looks like it's like a bit easy since all of them basically look the same. You can just erase out everything. But since I'm relatively new to it, I am new at it. It's my first time doing it. It was really difficult for me to figure out everything. So, but it is the final scene, so I got the hang of it by this point. But like the first scene was the first animation that I did for the whole program, and or the, for the whole personal project. And it was like the time it took for me to make this scene was like double the time it took for me to make the first scene. The first scene was like only 10 seconds long. This scene's 20 seconds. So yeah, I would say I improved during this process, this personal project. And also I tried to employ in my animation different techniques of animation. So in this website by Creative Blog, I discovered Disney's 12 principles of animation. And basically these were techniques and tips that taught people how to make their animations more appealing to look at. It was like squash and stretch, anticipation, staging, straight ahead, action, pose to pose. These were all techniques that I tried to keep in mind when doing my animation. So, you know, I also used, aside from these 12 techniques, I also used a commonly used technique in animation called the smear frame, where it's basically a frame that would take up, that would like take the place of maybe like five frames of the character moving. So it can, first of all, save time and also make the animation look more alive and like stretchy. So you might not notice it while it's in motion since it goes so fast. Well, now you might notice it since you know it's there. But yeah, it makes animation look smoother, I guess. So yeah, that's how the animation went. So next part was the sound effects. And the sound effects were relatively easy, you know. I just had to like breathe into my mic awkwardly and like cough or drop something and record the sound. Or I would use the piano as sound effects. So like you saw earlier, the bowling ball dropped and I used like a low tone piano. So that was how I recorded sound effects. It wasn't that hard. So for the third part, voice acting, also wasn't that hard. I planned to do a lot more lines of me speaking and screaming, mostly screaming, but I decided to make myself being the human in the story, to be like a mute guy who talks like the teacher from Charlie Brown, so that I didn't have to do more voice acting since I was so embarrassed by myself. And yeah, that's how the voice acting went, which I thought was decent for my acting skills. And the last part is the soundtrack. And as I said before, this is how I do my soundtrack. Relative, I already explained it. So that was how I made everything. It wasn't in line with the schedule exactly, as I showed here. I planned to finish the voice lines by October, but it ended up being finished by February. So that just displays my time management skills in a nutshell, but at least I got it done. And last thing I want to talk about in this criterion C is how well I translated my story to animation. So my story was like really dumb and nonsensical, and I really wanted to emphasize that with the animation. And so I made the dog look really dumb, like big eyes, like body, he's standing with two legs instead of the four legs. I made the human look like me, but I made him have Goku hair because he was pretty. I like Goku a lot, and so I wanted to make my animation look really absurd and really ugly, and on purpose because I kind of like that style. And yeah, that's what I think my story translated well to animation. Okay, first part, criterion the reflection and what I learned from this personal project experience. I learned a lot about animation and making music. I learned how to make a beat, a sick fat beat. I also learned animation, like the basics of it. I learned a lot of techniques, including these ones. So I'll make sure to employ them in future animations that I do. And I actually found this experience very fun, so fun that I decided to probably consider animation as something I could do like as a job in the future, or at least like a hobby, because I found it really fun. And difficulties experience would be majorly my time management skills. Those could have really been improved. I also could have improved the quality of my animation, because even if it's my first time animating, I found myself like leaving in mistakes, even if I could have easily fixed them, because I was just lazy and the time limit was already like really, the deadline was really near already. That's why I left it in the mistakes, but mostly because of laziness. An example of a mistake would be here somewhere, where there it's right there. You can see that his shoulder is being, the outline is being seen through his ear, and also I left some white dots on the neck because I rotated his head, but I didn't actually like draw a new head. I just like did something like I cropped out his head, then like moved it around. Oh wait, wrong layer. I moved it around like that, and that's why there are white dots remaining. It's like stitches. So yeah, I found myself seeing a lot of those mistakes and just leaving them in because I didn't care. Could have improved that, but you know, I can improve them later. I can't improve them now. I can't time travel. And finally, this personal project gave me a lot of appreciation for the aforementioned my research, which is Netflix, because I would visit some of my favorite animated movies, like some 2D animations. Like I would see little mistakes that are really small in the background, and I would be like, "Whoa, he did the same mistake as me. That's so cool." And I would like feel like I'm a professional because I did the same mistake as an actual professional animator, but really I wasn't because I'm bad and I'm just a newbie. So that's probably all the reflection I have. And the final score I would give myself in this personal project would probably be like, in terms of like a short, like this, if I was to judge this short film on its own as an individual art piece, I would give it probably like a 2 out of 10 because, not gonna lie, it's kind of pretentious because I'm kind of pretentious in my art, especially my art. And but as like a first time animation, someone who wrote or who learned animation just for this for the first time, I would give it like a 4 out of 8 because even though there are a lot of mistakes, even though there are a lot of sound design issues with the mixing and also the editing, I still thought that it was a good enough effort and it looks decent, at least decent. Like from some of the, like this, I'm proud of this drawing of me with wrinkles. I think it's pretty cool. So yeah, that's my presentation of my personal project.
See you there, I'm Precious from 10JG, and let's tune into the pandemic.
Okay, so this video would be all about my personal project presentation for this MYP. And to start off, I like to express my passion through art and music for my last journey of MYP.
We could say that this personal project is to use our interests or hobby to create a product out of it. However, in my case, this helped me through grade 10.
Because of the limited amount of materials I have at home, I need to use my open-minded mind or creative mindset to materialize what I have right now. And this expands my curiosity. How do I use these types of materials and learn different types of techniques within this project?
This leads to my statement. Through using tunes and a creative mindset, we could link our thoughts through a black piece of canvas.
Please tell us why.
So my goal was to create 12 to 14 canvases representing different types of emotions and tunes during this tough time.
by taking this chance, I also challenged myself using different types of medias. I'm also making a fun experience across grade 10. It will also challenge my creative output within this project.
People tend to forget their emotions. Let's just be real. They stress themselves with schoolwork and their jobs, and we don't really have much time to interact with our families and friends. Mostly right now, we're always stressing with schoolwork. So, only technology could help us interact with them. But I think there's a way for us to cope with this, individually or as a group. For example, journaling, painting, drawing, and much more. I want to take this opportunity to make this as my emotional journal, tracking my emotions within the tunes I listen through within the quarantine life. Remember, I always have to use my creative mindset, merging these songs with a paintbrush. Still, I consider myself as a beginner. I'm not as familiar with these types of materials and skills, therefore I want to improve with these kind of techniques and arts. And I will also be needing to research more about these things that would inspire me creating this output.
By the end, my outcome would be pieces of canvases, merging all of them together into one and creating an art wall, or a miniature art wall, you can say. Something like this for reference.
I chose to make an art wall because I've thought of creating a collage artwork compiling all the canvases in the corner of my room. It's been one of my goals to present what I have in mind and express it based on the music I've listened to, and also, this is another way for me to find my own art style. I've been trying to find the motivation to create my own style, so I'm taking this project as a chance for me to develop as a young artist. Also, I have excelled with using watercolors and pastels, but I plan to learn this specific technique, which is acrylic. I'm not as skillful with this type of material, however, within this project, I get to experience and give more time for this type of skill in arts. By the end, I've learned so much through this progress I've done for each artwork.
When you start your personal project, you would always need inspirations. For example, from your hobbies and interests, what sparked that interest? What sparked that passion? So for me, it was arts and music. I already did some research for arts, like the medias, the techniques, and the color schemes. For example, from the last video that you saw. Now, I'll be moving to music. Here, I'll show you like a screenshot of the music list that I used here. And as you can see, like the title is pretty relatable to the pandemic or like the COVID that's going on right now. And these are like emotions I felt during my personal project months in grade 10. So yeah, these are my inspiration, and I think music is a good way to express your emotions when it comes to creating art.
Hi, it's Precious here, editing, and I would just like to quickly note that if you want to follow my personal project inspiration playlist, here it is, and there's going to be a code here. So hope you guys liked the video so far, and yeah, have fun!
As you can see in this video, I have done a time lapse for each canvases that I've made and presented to you guys, adding up all the songs that I've used and inspired me for these few canvases that I'll be making. Again, for the final output, you'll see I'll be combining all the artworks together and I've done my goal, creating an art wall, of course. As an IB student, we should always utilize the ATL skills. I'll simply use three ATL skills that has been improving, which is my research, thinking, and self-management skills. Research skills were developed significantly during my project, and it shows me how much I care about researching because it helped me inspire me. Again, researching how artists create their songs or why they're created or they create this type of music. For example, in interviews, they've been a podcast or in radios they've been in, and I would go in depth and revise the lyrics and see what's the meaning and maybe getting the keywords out of it and converting it into drafts for just inspirations for my canvases. For my thinking skills, because of how many times I've brainstormed of what I need to add in a particular blank piece of canvas, I would always think of what is the best way to use or the technique or the color scheme. What is the mood? What is the emotion of that particular song? And I would manage to put them all together and also motivate myself and say, hey, you can do it, and brainstorm more about ideas to develop more canvases later on in the weeks. Lastly, self-management skills. It's been really improving every day after joining MYP, but I promised myself I would take a lot of time with every subject, and also being a balanced IB student, of course, and taking some time for my personal project as well. And also reminding myself to update at least twice or thrice a month for my process journal. That's what you need, guys. And also because the task will stay with you for 9 or 10 executive months for the last grade of MYP. As you can see in the video right now, it's a progress of my work around mid-January. And yeah, I put all the pieces of canvases together and put it on the wall so I could create an art wall. As an IB student, we have to reflect our own product or our own outcome. So in the following, I'll show you the categories of the criteria I've made, which are 4 of them, and guide questions like any criteria we have in class. To start off, we have criterion A, which is choosing tunes and art medias. For me, I would put myself in a level 6. I did show appropriate research for the topic and accessibility of the context research for my final product. Also merged my specific ideas to the link of my project, and also provide information and data, hence with clear citations like APA format. For criterion B, I did sketching and drafts. I would give myself a level 7 because I did show detailed evidence on what will I be showing, and also presented enough sketches to inspire me in my project, and also linked my ideas formats through my final project. For criterion C, I did demonstrate my emotions, so I'll also give myself a level 7. I did show expected emotions from the songs and scenarios. Also, I did an outstanding demonstration for the art media I'll be using, which is acrylic, and also showed an idea or message that I want to express. Lastly, for criterion D, we have visual context, so I think I'll give myself a level 6. Though I'm still a beginner, I think I have linked decently with the chosen tunes and art techniques. Also provide simple reflections in my process journal, and also did substantial ideas of how my final product would be like. Some unexpected challenges and opportunities has come and go within the months of this project for me. Honestly, it did improve a lot for my own interest and challenge me to know more about the future and maybe relate to my senior high life. At first, I think that this was not going to be a fun task. It would just be another burden for more tasks, but I think it's an interesting way to relax after classes. You could just do something you're interested at. This project is an excellent opportunity for students to expand their knowledge and understanding when it comes to creating their product by combining their interests and learning, and much more independent when it comes to tasking in MYP. Of course, my task from this project is using all the ATL skills regarding to research, communication, social thinking, and much more. So what I learned from this project is all the art skills and how I can use them in the future. I think that this personal project really helped me improve skill, not just only that, being open-minded with different types of challenges that you take in. So for the future students who will get into grade 10 in MYP, remember that you'll also improve your ATL skills and your IB attributes. But again, have a balanced life, have fun, and give time for yourself. Always remember, pursue your dream, pursue your interest. Life is too short. That's all I got to say, and this is Precious signing off.
Ever since
Since I was a kid, drawing has always been a part of my life. From the moment I saw my sisters sketch on their very own 6x9 Corona sketchbook to the moment that I begged my mom to show me how to draw while waiting for tutoring to finish, I knew that I fell in love. That is why, in this personal project, I decided to, of course, draw. But to challenge myself, I obviously wouldn't just draw anything that popped into my mind. So, as a result, I chose to follow the theme of drawing historical and traditional clothing all over the world. Because I recently caught an interest in traditional garments among different cultures, why not? In creating this project, I wanted to draw 7 different countries on a sketchbook and flip through it after I'm completely finished. Through the process of drawing and painting each piece, I had a lot of ups and downs, and a few burnouts here and there as well. With the process of creating art, I was always reminded that not all of your creations are going to end up perfect. It took me a lot of time to accept that, since I wanted my sketchbook to look as good as possible, and consequently, this led to a lot of creative burnouts and art blocks. But through it all, I guess you could say that I was able to persevere because, number one, I'm talking to you right now, and number two, creating art and doing this project isn't about creating something perfect, but it's really about improving your own skills. So, go where the pen takes you, I guess. And don't be afraid to be disappointed sometimes. It's a part of the process. For my first country being Germany, I had a lot of fun doing this. While I was quite slow in painting the first few pieces, I managed to pick up my pace after warming up. In most of these drawings, I mainly took inspiration from photos, magazines, and videos of fashion in 20th century Germany. However, I also took liberties with taking references from 15th century peasant clothing for women. For their more cultural and traditional garments, I would look at films and images of dirndls and lederhosen. In this section, my favorite piece out of the bunch would most definitely be the last drawing of the portrait of a girl, as I really liked how I framed the composition. I also like the references that I took for this, as the modern Shaw magazines that I based it off of really had interesting silhouettes and a very vintage vibe. With Kenya, my second country, I had a very fun and interesting experience, even though it posed quite the challenge with all of the intricate details in its accessories. For most of the drawings, I mainly took inspiration from the Maasai culture in Kenya, as they had these very bright and bold colors, which to me was a very interesting element to experiment and play with. But that doesn't mean that I only took references from this culture alone. As Kenya has a lot of villages, I was inspired by the more traditional and historical dresses of the Borana community. Not only that, but I also tried to incorporate more modern and contemporary elements, especially with clothing from the Pamba culture. While I think I could have improved on the anatomy in my drawings, I really like the piece where the man and girl are sitting on grass, as I'm not that used to drawing backdrops because I sometimes have a difficult time with the details. So, seeing as I was able to accomplish that is very rewarding. For my third country, which is Vietnam, I was mainly dissatisfied with the outcome of it. I'm not saying that the art was extremely bad, but I felt that I could have done a lot better with the styles that I used for this country. I decided to experiment more with the media that I use, since I usually just use watercolor or markers. Therefore, I wanted to play with the textures of media like gouache. With that being said, my main inspirations for this section would be the Altai garments and the non-Batam hats, since I noticed that while Vietnamese clothing has different variations and types for each social class, practicality and simplicity seems to be very common traits for this country's clothes.
Although I definitely still have some of my favorites, such as the man in blue, I feel that some of the expressions I drew were lacking in comparison to the other countries. But at least I was able to learn from what I could have potentially done better. With the next country of Peru, I can definitely say that with 100% confidence, this was my favorite section to paint in. Not only was I able to learn from my mistakes in past drawings, but I was also able to improve on it here. While I was not able to find much information about Peru's historical garments, I still found some videos detailing the cultural and traditional practices that they did and still do today. Mostly taking inspiration from the traditional Andean clothing, I think I was able to do a good job with this since I made sure to draw every detail and compensation for the lack of historical information. An interesting thing that I discovered from researching information about Peru would be how there are a lot of Native American influences and groups in their history. From a documentary that I found that was produced by the Encyclopedia Britannica Films, I was able to make clearer references. With the country of Indonesia, I felt that I had a much better time drawing the latter part of this section. As I became more meticulous with the details, I was able to become more familiar with the structure of their clothing. The main element that's very striking in their culture would be the significance of headdresses in different events. Because of this detail, I wanted to make sure to incorporate that into some of the drawings. Overall, I think that my favorites out of this bunch would be the pieces of the girl wearing a headdress and the two kids sitting, as I feel like the colors and details really blended together well. For Russia, there were a lot of different references for different time periods, so for the most part, there was a lot of material that I was able to use, as the references I gathered were more modern in comparison to the other countries. Due to it being more set in the 20th century, I tried to let it reflect in the styles I used. With the styles, I became very invested with the silhouettes that different eras offered, as in some periods, there were rounder and chunkier textures and shapes, while in other periods, the shapes and shoulders were wider and boxier in comparison. In general, I believe that, similar to the other countries, I had a very fun learning experience, as while I was able to learn about the culture, I was also able to improve upon my set skills. For the last country, which is Bolivia, I had quite the challenging time as the clothing and garments were very similar to the country of Peru. However, this does not mean that they don't have any differences, as I believe that one of the defining traits or groups in Bolivia would be the Cholita fashion, which is a more modern era of clothing inspired by the historical and traditional women's clothing. As I was drawing these, I wasn't quite satisfied with the way some of the drawings turned out because I feel that they could have been more refined or polished. Because there were some anatomical mistakes, I believe that I could have definitely improved. All in all, I think that, well, at first, I didn't feel that what I was doing was enough. I think I pulled through at the end because seeing the final product in its entirety kind of makes me feel like I accomplished something worthwhile, which I can share to others. Opening doors towards other cultures through the use of art and fashion is something that has and still really interests me because it can really bring people together to learn different things, regardless of one's age, gender, race, etc. Therefore, with this, I guess what I want to say is that feeling dissatisfied or tired with something is normal. So, instead of treating this as a negative thing, I believe that we should instead treat this as a human response. After all, we all need to take a break, and we all need to learn from ourselves.